Hey guys, Dustin with the Custom Offsets here, and we are back at Lifted Truck National. Someone is waving to me from across. Yeah, there we go. Anyway, we're back at Lifted Truck Nationals, and we're coming to you with an episode of From the Gallery. Today, I'm joined by a special guest. Actually, I'm joined by Bug BMX.
What's up, everyone? How we doing?
It's good to have you, buddy. I'm excited. I'm stoked
to be here.
Thanks for joining us. So, yeah, we're back with another episode of From the Gallery. It's where we take your gallery ads, rate them on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being not so great, 10 being pretty much freaking awesome. Remember, before we do that, wheels, tires, or suspension, customoffsets.com is where you can get those. We're also doing a full build giveaway. So we're actually giving away Archon wheels, Mickey Thompson tires, and a Superlift suspension system shipped right to the winner's door.
Pretty cool.
All you got to do to get entered to win is pick up one of these t-shirts. Customoffsets.com/giveaway.
Do it.
Cool. All right, let's do it. Up first is a 2020 Ram 1500 TIS 544s black and milled, 24x12s. Toyo Open Country MTs and a 37 13.5 and a 6-inch BDS lift kit. Can we just talk about how Mopar does this cool thing where a 6-inch lift kit you can clear 37s?
Yes.
It's pretty freaking awesome.
I mean, you've seen in forums for years, like, everyone asking, like, can I clear 37s?
Yes.
Yes, you can.
Yes. It's crazy. So I see this one is that, like, it looks like a dark blue color, or
yeah.
Is it black?
Is it
and
charcoal?
Maybe my computer screen's not very bright. It's super bright down here in Missouri, but either way,
I'll figure it out.
Looks like he spaced the front bumper out an inch, trimmed the wheel wells, which I would expect for 37s.
Yep.
You know, other than that, really a pretty stock truck. He's got a burnout pick, so
I'll take the burnout pick. I'm sure that transmission loved that.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure it loved it a ton. It's crazy though. He said he spaced the bumper, but you can't really tell.
What do you mean, spaced the bumper? Right?
So he put shims behind it, so it kicks it further out, gives him more clearance.
I don't know. I never even thought of that. I just use a sawzall.
Just cut it. It'll be
just
fine.
Cut it.
All right. Are you ready to rate it?
I'm ready.
3, 2, 1, 7. Yep. Same thing. Neat truck. Looks good. Good wheel choice. I mean, the 544 is solid on literally everything.
Oh, yeah. It looks like a good daily. I love the front end of those trucks.
For real. I'd like to see some window tint, maybe some bumper action.
Let's get rid of that fishbowl mod.
For real. Up next. What in the f*** is this?
Damn.
1931 Ford Model A. K3 Project. Project 1 wheels. I've never even heard of these before.
No, this is dope.
20x9s in the rear. 20x9s in the front, excuse me. 20x11s in the rear. Just random tires. It doesn't say what brand. And air suspension. So hold on a second. So this is a Model A on 20-inch wheels, and it's
slammed.
It's bagged?
Yeah. I'm about this.
Rowdy, dude.
This is definitely rowdy. This would hurt some feelings.
For real. I'm just looking. I mean, obviously, it's a Model A, so completely custom front end. That wheel choice is fantastic.
That's good. The
it
white wall tires,
so good.
And everything.
It just lays frame.
Yeah.
The whole door panel.
I need this. I want it.
This would look super dope on your truck.
This
would,
yeah.
Going down the road,
this
would look, you know what I'm saying? I'm ready. I don't need to talk about it anymore.
Let's get it going.
All right. 3, 2, 1.
10.
Yeah, without a doubt. All day, every day. The amount of work that goes into something like this is crazy.
Yeah.
You know, just the custom fabrication.
Yes.
Is insane.
I respect this build a ton. I want to see it in person.
Yeah, I want to rip some wild burnouts in it, dude.
I feel like this thing would really hoon good.
Oh, yeah. Without a doubt. Up next, back to the truck world.
Okay. All right.
2019 Ford F-250 Super Duty. This one's on Archon Alexanders in a 24x14. Ironman All-Country MTs in a 40 15.5 and a 9.5-inch Skyjacker suspension lift.
Big.
I think it's cool that you see Skyjacker starting to come back again.
Yeah, I think that's a good thing.
Because they were around for a while, and then they kind of stepped back. You know, they were one of the forerunners, I remember, like, when we were kids.
Exactly,
you know? And then they kind of fell back and just hid behind the scenes, and now they're making stuff for newer trucks again. So it's an 8.5-inch four-link in the front, 2.5-inch level spacer on top of that, blocks in the rear with the Adelief, a little bit of trimming, which I would expect with something that big, you know. This thing is neat.
I like it.
I love this wheel choice. The Alexanders have always been a wheel that by themselves I never really liked.
Uh-huh.
But when you put them on a truck, they look super good.
Yeah, it's got a clean, classy, sharp look to it.
Correct. Look at the poke on this. Just hanging
there
outside
we go.
The wheel.
It's my style.
Yikes.
It could always be a little more, though.
Correct.
Never enough.
I like how there's, like, this is, like, more bars and more places. It's, like, stock. 4-inch lift, 9.5.
Yep. Is that painted bumpers, or do they come like that factory?
They might be painted. Yeah, it's either, it depends on what trim package it is, but he could have painted them. It looks good.
Yeah, it looks way good.
It looks way better than like a chrome or a black bumper on this, you know.
Also looks like it could still, you know, put in some good work.
Correct.
Be a daily, drive it.
Very, very
not too much of a headache. Yeah.
So, yeah, absolutely. All right, let's rate it.
All right.
3, 2, 1.
9.
8.5. Yep. I'm in the same boat. For me, it's a super practical daily. Of course, we're talking practical daily with a 9.5-inch lift on 40s, so it's literally that big.
Yeah. Maybe that's the thing. You know, we're looking at pictures. It's different when you're in person. Maybe, I don't know. It looks practical. we'll have to ask him.
It's true. But it does look good. I feel like you could hook this to a trailer, tow stuff around, not have to worry about
still
it.
Still take it camping and whatnot. Use
correct.
The truck.
Exactly. So... cool. Ooh, baby. Up next is a 06 Chevy Silverado 2500. Sell me your truck. I want it, please. Yeah. I'm looking for one of these, actually.
Good old cat eye.
Hostile Alpha 24x14s, Aturo Trailblade Boss, which is the gnarly tire Aturo makes that looks like a knife.
Yeah, that thing is wild.
375/40s, which are about 30, just over 35x14.5s, and a 9-inch McGoy suspension lift kit. This thing's freaking neat.
Yeah, this is dope.
I'm such a sucker for a clean cat eye.
This, this body style, anything up and above, they just kind of went backwards, I feel like.
Yeah, I mean, I like the 14 to 18s as well, but this is like...
this is the best.
For real, and they look so good. And then up in Wisconsin, all the cat eyes are rusted out.
Yeah.
But down here in Missouri, like, we're driving around, I'm seeing them all over the place, and they're in good shape.
Yep. This is going to be the classic vintage truck someday that you want to... you want to find.
This is the
buy it now, throw it in the garage, don't touch it.
Correct. This is the OBS Chevy of like 2030.
Yep, 2030.
Absolutely.
2030 is going to be a $100,000 show truck.
Oh, yeah, all day long. So it's crazy. I see he's got some powder coat. Looks like it's a like almost
white,
like a robin egg blue or something,
blue,
I can't tell. It's definitely blue. And then he's got the white cross member
I
in the
like
middle
that.
There.
Breaking it up.
McGoy's make such a beautiful cross
they
member.
They do.
With, you know, they've got all the like... diagonal cuts out of it. A couple of decals on the front windshield there. Oh, it's got a big old Workforce
sticker. It's got the Workforce sticker.
I know he hangs out, D-Max Rhino hangs out with a couple of
guys. Shout out D-Max Rhino.
Cat eyes, yeah. He's a super nice guy too, by the way, if you've ever met him.
Yep, got to meet him at SEMA last year. Way cool dude.
Super, super chill, so. But yeah, powder coat bits up and underneath there. Looks like he's got a rear diff cover, tinted the taillights. Nice build overall.
Yeah, really clean.
Cool, ready to rate it?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. 3, 2, 1,
10.
8.
I'm giving this one a 10.
This is a 10, huh?
Yeah, it reminds me of my first, like I said, I had that same body style, the 04 LV7, and this is kind of digging into my heart a little bit. Makes me miss it.
Yeah, it hits the soft spot.
It hits home, for sure.
Like I said, I really want one of these. Maybe I should have rated it a little higher. He probably won't sell me his truck.
You sell it to me, right?
That's true. But for me, it's almost there. It just needs a little bit. I'm not a huge, super big fan of the halogen headlights on these trucks.
Yeah.
I think some of the, like the OLED, you know, replacements look really, really good.
For sure.
And then, I mean, other than that, I'd maybe like to see some of this chrome either
Painted
to match or blacked out or something. It
Agreed.
Just, you know, it sticks out a little bit.
Yeah.
But beautiful truck. Cool. Let's do the last one here then. 2012
Ooh.
Ford F-250 Super Duty fuel cleavers and a 24x16, which is a wide boy.
Yeah.
Fury Country Hunter MTs 40x15.5, and it just says PMF lifted greater than 12 inches, which is pretty obvious.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that thing's big.
So FOA adjustable coilover set up at 12.5, 8-inch leaf springs with a 3-inch block on top of it.
Dang.
So 12.5 up front, 11 in the rear. Oh, man, this thing is beautiful. Rock lights, you know, blaring right there. Aftermarket front grille.
Good looking headlights.
Yeah, I mean.
That's actually, my last truck had those same wheels, same size and everything.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I love those cleavers.
It's a super unique wheel because, again, I feel like this is like the Alexander where you look at it on the wall and you're like,
ew, no.
This is gross.
Yeah.
And then
I didn't like them until they were on the truck. They're wild. They get a lot of attention.
Yeah. I think it's because they're so aggressive when they roll, you know?
Yep.
You know, wheel lights going on in there and all sorts of cool stuff. I mean, this thing is...
This is nicely done. Very tasteful.
Correct.
Oh, that's a good picture right
there. Oh, man. Look how wide those wheels are, dude. They're freaking gnarly.
That's good looking. I like this one a lot.
And it's only furthered by the fact that this is a wide-angle photo, so it fisheyes a little bit. So the front and rear wheels just look massive.
Not my favorite body style of Ford, though.
Stock versus current. Ooh. Look at that.
Yeah,
that's a cool
photo.
That's
a big come up.
Best glow up of 2020 right
here. Yes, sir.
Cool. Let's rate it, huh?
I'm ready.
Three, two, one,
eight.
9.
Giving this one an 8.
Yep. super cool truck. It looks really good. He's got a ton of time into this one.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah, I guess my only dig is, like you said, not maybe my favorite body style Ford.
I'm really digging the newer body style.
Oh, my God. They look so good.
I need one, I think.
Same. Well, there you go, guys. There is another episode of From the Gallery. Thank you, Bug, so much for joining us today. Yeah. It's been a pleasure to have
you. Thanks for having me. It's been fun.
Remember, if you want to check him out, you can find him at BugBMX on Instagram and YouTube, right?
Yes, sir. That's it.
Cool. And if you want the chance for your truck to be rated, you're going to want to add it to the gallery. You can do that, customoffsets.com/add. And that's it.
Peace.
We're done.